generally New Zealand is going up because of that convergence across the plate boundary. Something interesting is happening off the eastern margin of the North Island of New Zealand, and that is where the Pacific plate is going down, being pushed down under the Australian plate, and it locks, it grips, and it pulls the land down. So in the lower North Island and on the eastern side of the lower North Island, the land is actually subsiding, going down at quite high rates of up to 8 millimetres per year. Right here, the subsidence is 3 to 4 millimetres per year, which is effectively doubling the amount of sea level rise we can expect right now and in the coming decades and centuries. So this part of New Zealand is exposed to some fairly big swell waves that get generated down around Antarctica. So this part of New Zealand already gets big storm events that at a high tide causes coastal flooding, and these buildings around us are often in the news and getting damaged by those storm events. Now the problem with the subsidence is that it's really amplifying the amount of sea level rise we will get over the coming decades. So by 2050, globally, we would expect an average sea level rise of about 30 centimetres. You can double that for this spot, so that'll be 50 to 60 centimetres in the coming decades. And that cannot be avoided. That is already baked in from the global warming so far. So what that means is that the 100-year coastal flooding event we currently get now that does a lot of damage to the roads and the houses around this part of Wellington will become an annual event with just 30 centimetres of global sea level rise, but 60 centimetres right here because of the land going down.